Good afternoon. Welcome to the Cathedral of the Holy Cross. Most of us have been here all day preparing quite diligently, and it's been a wonderful, fun experience. We want to thank everyone for coming out in the lovely weather. Some of the choirs have traveled a long way from New Hampshire and Connecticut through all this weather. We're going to begin some of the prelude now. There are some additional prelude pieces that are not in your program. And the first that you will hear is from the Immaculate Heart of Mary School, director Michael Olbash. They will be singing the Lacrimosa by Mozart. And then after, the St. Paul's Choir School will be singing the Stabat Mater by Pergolesi, and O Sacrum Convivium by James Kennerley, who is also our guest conductor today. Thank you very much for being here.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I fail to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. O God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord said to Abram, "Go forth from the land of your kinsfolk and from your father's house to a land that I will show you. I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you. I will make your name great, so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you and curse those who curse you. All the communities of the earth shall find blessing in you." Abram went as the Lord directed him. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, bear your share of hardship for the gospel with the strength that comes from God. He saved us and called us to a holy life, not according to our works, but according to his own design and the grace bestowed on us in Christ Jesus before time began, but now manifest through the appearance of our Savior Christ Jesus, who destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John, and led them up a high mountain by themselves, and he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Lord, it is good that we are here. If you wish, I will make three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them. Then from the cloud came a voice that said, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. When the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, Rise and do not be afraid. And when the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one else but Jesus alone. As they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, Do not tell the vision to anyone until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
I don't know about you people, but I don't go to the movies much anymore. COVID kind of did a number on movie theaters to begin with. But also, whenever I go to a movie, I typically fall asleep. So I say to myself, why am I going to pay $12 to fall asleep? Also, I have a pretty big TV, I will confess. And my chair is really comfortable, and the popcorn at home is really cheap. But still, whether I'm in a theater or I'm watching Netflix or Prime Video, something like that, I really enjoy the previews. Because in fact, sometimes, let's face it, they're better than the movie or the series. Speaking of previews, we just heard chanted Matthew's account of one of the gospel's most incredible visions. Peter, James, and John had this brief but overwhelming experience on the mountain before their very eyes. This Jesus they had known and had walked with and listened to and spoken with, their friends, was before their very eyes transfigured. His face became as radiant as if you were looking at the sun. His garments as white as light. And the music, the soundtrack that must have been playing, well, it would have been like being here today. Like being in heaven, you guys. That's how beautiful the music you make is. And at Jesus' side, enveloped in glory, stood Moses, who had led Israel out of slavery, and Elijah, one of the great Old Testament prophets. And there they were in conversation with Jesus. And as you can imagine, the disciples were just awestruck and at the same time confused. So Peter fumbled for the right words. Master, it is good for us to be here. Let's set up three tents. Let's build three condos. This event is recorded in all three of the synoptic gospels, Matthew, Mark, and Luke. And it's also referenced in other places in the New Testament. So it certainly was a very significant event. However, how does this brilliant, strange occurrence that we hear on this second Sunday of Lent, how does this have any impact on us? What does it have to do with us? Could this perhaps be a preview of coming attractions? But wait a minute. I thought we were dust, and to dust we shall return. Perhaps we need to scratch beneath the surface of the dust. Since we live here in the dust, in the messiness of this world, clothed in penitential purple, this Lent we need to dig down deep to get a clear vision of the reality that God has in store for us. My friends, sin is as real as grace. Evil lurks among us, no matter what our age. We've witnessed it vividly in terrible acts of war and terrorism, in mass shootings and other breaking news every day, it seems like. We see it in the abandonment of the child in the womb. and of the elderly, sick, and poor. As human beings, we have inclinations that go against all that God hopes for us. However, as I say, grace is very real too. The reality and the glory of the resurrection, which is the goal of our Lenten observance, the victory of Jesus is the ultimate solution to all of this. This is our hope. According to St. Paul, we have our citizenship in heaven. That's where we truly belong, God's kingdom. Jesus will change this lowly body of ours and conform it to his own glorified body. We have tremendous hope in him. In fact, he is our only hope. At St. Matthew's Church in Dorchester, where I once served as pastor, carved in the marble above the altar are the words of St. Thomas Aquinas, "Adoro te, devote, latens deitas." O hidden God, here I devoutly adore you. This is so true for us here at Mass this afternoon. Here, devoutly, we encounter the hidden God. But not only here. All of our lives are blessed with previews, brief moments of intense awareness of the living God. However, in our humanity, in our brokenness, how easily and quickly we forget. It might have been walking on the beach and seeing the sunset. It might have been holding your child or your grandchild for the first time. It might have been while assisting at someone's death, or on Christmas morning, or during confession, or while standing on skis on the side of a mountain trail, or here, inspired by this beautiful music in this cathedral made glorious by the generosity of so many and our rector, Monsignor O'Leary. Here, the veil is lifted, if but for a moment in time, and the hidden God becomes visible, tangible, as food for our treacherous journey. We must remember and treasure these moments when God reveals to us the fullness of life. These previews, these glimpses of eternity are given to us for our encouragement. It's so good for us to be here. Remember this. Here we meet the hidden God, like in no other place or circumstance. Treasure this moment as God, in a supreme act of generosity, empties himself in sacrifice for us once again. Watch and pray for those privileged moments when God gives you a preview of coming attractions. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor has it so much as dawned on the human heart what God has prepared for those who love him. Lord, it is good for us to be here.
And so let us profess together our Catholic faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We have been called to a holy life. We pray now for the graces God has prepared for us before the world began.
For the Church, that we may be transfigured more and more into the image and likeness of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to listen, that we may hear the voice of Christ in prayer, events, and relationships, so that we may respond more fully to God's invitation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For freedom from fear, that God will cleanse our hearts and help us to live in the freedom of the children of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are facing a crisis, loss, or low points in their lives, that they may experience the transforming grace of God and grow in their trust of God to bring forth a new beginning and an abundant life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For openness of heart, that as we prepare to celebrate the sacrament of penance, we may discover God's unbounded love that desires to forgive and free us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are deceased, especially Anne Langan, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, hear our prayers, and may our observance of Lent make us ever more faithful to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told the disciples of his coming death, on the holy mountain he manifested to them his glory, to show, even by the testimony of the law and the prophets, that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim.
Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Sean Patrick, our Bishop, me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all of us gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In commemoration with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, He took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants, and your holy people, from the gifts that you have given us, offer to you this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in the fellowship of your holy apostles and martyrs with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, O Lord, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. As we receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us while still on earth to be partakers even now of the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
That was spectacular, by the way. I just want you to know. I did feel like I was in heaven. What a wonderful day. Congratulations to all those who have participated in this day in which we give glory to God with our voices. And congratulations for this great achievement to all of you. Absolutely heavenly.
The Lord be with you. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Our help is in the name of the Lord. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.